humanity survived. Our ancestors have destroyed the world, and we had to pay the price. With over 100 years without sunlight, but we have prepared ourselves for our chance to make things right. They stole from us a life of happiness. Still, we will make the best of it. Even though Mother Earth is grim and tainted, we have managed to survive. And we will keep surviving.
We finally left the end zone. Just look at this beautiful scenery. It's marvelous, even though it's a bit different from what we had pictured. We were able to secure a few basic resources and are storing them in our bus. I'm glad we prepared ourselves well for this kind of scenario, especially since our inventories in the end zone ran low. Don't forget that if you need additional information, you can look at our survival guide at any time. Everything you need to know should be right here. I think the time has come for us to at last build ourselves a new home here. Before we can construct buildings at all, we have to assign the profession builder to several settlers so that they can take care of construction contracts. In general, it's your responsibility to decide which tasks are important and how our settlers are supposed to be distributed to attend to them. Construction contracts have been issued. It's time to start focusing on our key and most basic. The first thing we ought to do is to establish a working water supply. So we'll move on to our first construction contract. Place and build a jetty by a lake in the vicinity of your town center. completed as planned. Now we have a place where we can collect water. There are other possibilities to gather water too, but the jetty is the simplest and most cost-effective method. We can obtain and store water from different sources, like a jetty, rain collector, or well in the cistern. The cistern should always be in close proximity to a water source so that our water carriers don't. Installed a working water supply, and water is now transported from the jetty to our cistern. Consider hiring more water carriers if you don't have enough settlers available. You can never have enough water in storage. Now we should focus on food production. It's important to ensure the supply right from the start. A gatherer's cabin, a hunting lodge, or a fishing hut can directly remedy the situation. I suggest starting with a fishing hut, since we're already located near a lake.
Thank you.
taken care of our basic supply via food and water. Make sure that you have enough food and water on hand at all times, especially if you want to upgrade your settlement. A population that grows too fast can quickly unbalance your food and water supply, bringing major difficulties for you. Crops are another excellent way of getting food because they constantly grow as long as the soil is moist enough. Each seed has different yields and growing times. This means that it could take some time until your field is ready to be harvested. In contrast to your fishing hut, where production can be right away.
Distribute resources within your settlement.